Hello, good morning student. Again we are here. Now today onwards we'll start our first chapter. As I told you yesterday, I'll start electrostatics. In this chapter, as it is written here, the definition of electrostatics is the study of behavior or properties of charges at rest is known as electrostatics. It is related to electrical charges, and main thing is that the charge should be at rest condition. This is the most important word here, rest condition. If the charges will move, then it will be electrodynamics, not electrostatic. It will produce electric current. But here in this electrostatic, main condition is that the charges should be in rest condition. Now, next is, what is electrical charges? Now, as it is written here, the charge is an electrical property of constituent particles of nature due to which they can apply electric force on each other. As you already have studied in gravitation in class 11, that similarly electrostatic and gravitation almost little bit similar to each other, there is difference. But as you know that mass is the gravitational property, similarly charges is the electrical property. And now in electrical charge, the SI unit of charge is generally written as coulomb. It is shown written here, coulomb. Either you can write in word or you can, symbol is capital C. Symbol of electrical charge is generally written as small b when the charge is smaller. In case of smaller charge, we will write small b. In case of less charge, we will write q naught. And in case of bigger charge, we will write q. Now, as we know that every material is constituted of billions number of atoms. Atoms as a whole is a neutral, and every atom consists of three main particles except hydrogen. Hydrogen consists of two particles, electron and proton. But other than hydrogen, every other atom consists of at least three particles, electron, proton and neutron. These are generally called elementary charge particles. The charge of electron is denoted by minus E sign, charge of proton is denoted by plus E sign, and charge of neutron is zero. The magnitude of electron, charge of electron is this much, 1.6 × 10⁻⁹. I request you, it will be better for you to memorize this value. It will come and close as we follow the next lesson. Now, so next thing is, what is charging process? There are different types of charging process. As I have written here, there are three charging processes. One is charging by friction, which is called electrical friction basically, and it is in general it is called rubbing. Number two is charging by conduction method, and number three is charging by induction method. Today I will discuss only charging by friction method or rubbing. As you already know, in class 6-7 you have read that when we have a glass rod with a silk cloth, then after some time, when we hold both the things close to each other, it will attract to each other. Now, if it is the silk cloth, and if we consider this is the glass rod, if we rub like this, some electrons from the glass rod is transferred from glass rod to silk cloth. As you know, electrons are negatively charged, and as electrons is transferring from glass rod to silk cloth, so this silk cloth becomes negatively charged body, and this glass rod, as it is deficiency of number of electrons, it becomes positively charged. Now when we hold this glass rod and silk cloth very close to each other, it will attract to each other. So in this way, by rubbing method, or we can produce a charged body. And next two method we will discuss later on. Now, what are the properties of electrical charges? As already you know that there are basically two types of charges. One is positive charge and another is negative charge. Generally it is denoted by in this way. Now, these are the basically two types of electrical charges. Next property is, two equal charges are repelled to each other and two opposite charges are attracted to each other. Now, if we place two equal charges, if this is glass charge, if this is glass charge, it will repel to each other. Similarly, if we place two negative charges very close to each other, it will repel to each other. It will repel. Now, if we place two opposite charges, if we place two opposite charges, it will attract to each other. In this way, charge two equal charges repel to each other and two opposite charges attract to each other. Now, next property is additive. Electrical charges are additive in nature. Electrical charges are additive in nature. It means that electrical charges are scalar. We can add algebraic way all the electrical charges. Suppose here 3 positive charges, 4, 5 positive charges are there, and here 3 negative charges. 3 negative charges. Now, what is it? If you want to find the total number, total charge is, what is the total charge of this system? We simply add. We have to add this positive charge and negative charge. Some will cancel and we will get one charge. So simply we have to add algebraic. So that's why charges are additive in nature. We can add simply algebraic two charges. Next is property is invariant. What is invariant? Now, if this jug possesses some charge, suppose this is positively charged, but object, if it is rest condition and we are considering that charge possessed by this positively charged body is 2 coulomb, and in rest condition, what is the charge is 2 coulomb, but when it is moved with any time, any velocity, the charge will be always remain same, 2 coulomb. It does not depend on the speed of the charged body. That's why it is invariant. It is, but here we can say that already I told you in class 11 that mass is not invariant. Mass is will change with the speed of the object. So mass is not invariant, but electrical charges is invariant. Next is concept. Charge, electrical charges in an isolated system is always in conserve. We cannot create electrical charges, or we cannot destroy any electrical charges. In a whole system, total charges is always in conserve. Let me give one example. Now, as it is the silk cloth and it is a glass rod. Before rubbing, it is neutral, it is also neutral. So total charge, if we consider this this system consists of one glass rod and one this silk rod. So total charge of this system is here zero. But after rubbing, what happened? This glass rod becomes positively charged and this silk rod becomes negatively charged. Now, in this isolated system, what will be the total charge? Total charge will also remain same. Means before rubbing, what will be the total? That zero. Because some of the electrons, suppose 1000 numbers of electrons transferring from this this glass rod to this cloth. Now this cloth becomes 1000 times negatively charged. This glass rod becomes 1000 times positively charged. So total charge of this system of these two body, glass rod and silk rod, becomes zero. So before rubbing, total charge is zero. After rubbing, total charge is zero. And this is for conservation of charge. And this is one property. Last number six property of electrical charges is quantization. Electrical charges is quantized. This is the most important properties of electrical charges. As I gave one example, again I am showing how it is quantized. Now when we are rubbing this glass rod with this silk rod, what happened? Some numbers of electrons is transferring from this glass rod to this silk rod. How many numbers of electrons are transferring? It is always integral multiple number, not a fractional number. This condition is called quantized condition. Mathematically, you can write the quantized condition like this: Q equal to plus minus N E, where N is integral number and E is charge of electron. If the charge, as we know, that charge of electron, magnitude of charge of electron is E plus E, E, and it is the same for proton also. So when the charge body is positive, then we can use this formula Q equal to plus N. And when the charge is negative body, we can use this formula Q equal to minus N. So in general, we have to use this formula. This is the formula using for quantized condition. These are the properties of electrical charges. Now I just request you just go through these basic things, okay? And after uploading this video lecture, we will send some numerical problem with solve, and some will you have to solve, and I will. Again, anyone have any doubt in this lecture, you just ask question tomorrow, and also try to solve the numerical problem. So, and tomorrow I will again give any doubt in these basic things, I will explain tomorrow also. Okay.